I'm 23 ABC's Ken Masenchi. I'll never forget that face, a phrase we've heard or possibly even used. But this reenactment of a common crime is meant to show you that you might forget that face just seconds after you saw it.
No! My purse!
Did you see him? Let's rewind, though in the real world, there is no replay. Here he comes. Don't blink. An eyewitness is startled and turns to look, but what could they actually see? You really only have a couple seconds, so how reliable is eyewitness identification?
In some circumstances, human vision can be most excellent. And in other instances where you have time constraint, movement, low lighting, emotional distress, fear, the ability of the person to make a valid eyewitness identification is severely compromised. Because what we think we can see is not necessarily what we can in fact see.
That might be scary to consider because many cases rely heavily on witnesses, victims, and what they saw or what they think they saw.
It isn't uncommon for witnesses sometimes to have seen everything and provide information that may be completely different from another witness who saw the exact same thing.
But what you see and what you remember seeing can be altered in the time it takes an officer to get to the scene.
Information, sometimes bad information, can be spread from one witness to another.
Suddenly you're telling an officer not only what you saw, but what another witness told you they saw, shifting your memory of what actually happened.
The trouble with memory is it is not a static thing. Memories can be influenced by subsequent influencers. Every time the memory is tested, it can alter the memory.
Defense attorney Clayton Campbell has studied the science of eyewitness identification extensively because he has helped victims wrongfully ID'd.
We have the technology and the science to be about as certain about anything as we have ever been in the history of the world. So there's no excuse for us to continually follow these patterns of improper eyewitness identification procedures, ignoring the science and convicting the wrong people.
The practices Campbell is referring to are six-pack photo IDs and lineups, which he says are outdated and filled with bias. But Sergeant Ryan Croker, the Bakersfield Police Department, disagrees.
We try to put as many countermeasures in place to let people understand that we're not trying to be leading. We're not trying to get them to identify somebody who's not responsible, but just get an accurate depiction of what they remember.
All three admit that in the moment, it can be nearly impossible to focus on a person's face and decipher distinguishing information, especially if a weapon is involved.
One's survival depends upon whether or not their assailant is going to use the weapon.
Mm-hmm.
So that's more important than giving a description on whether or not the suspect had a mustache.
If you're in the middle of that situation, I do not expect you to think back to this news story and think, oh, what did that guy say I should do? You know, nobody expects you to be able to do that.
Though you aren't expected to remember it at the time, what you tell yourself you remember could make all the difference in the courtroom.
Limitations of human vision are not regularly challenged in court.
Do you think it should be?
I think it should be. If the victim or a witness believes in their heart that they're describing what they think they saw, they can be very, very convincing.
Very convincing, but possibly very wrong.
You don't want to acknowledge that because now you're admitting that you're still in danger.
Leading many to convince themselves that they'll never forget the face of the person who wronged them.
I believe that people who express with such confidence that they would never forget that face, I believe that they believe that. Okay, so I don't think they're lying. I think they're mistaken, though. And I think it's far more common than people let on.
Proving that even though you say it's a face you'll never forget, a variety of factors may cause you to forget it seconds after you saw it. And it's okay to admit that.
And while the eye possesses capabilities a camera doesn't have, Campbell and Croker say taking video or snapping a picture on your smartphone can provide a second pair of eyes, ones that aren't subject to a changing memory. Just make sure you don't put yourself in more danger. In studio, Ken Masenchi, back to you.
All right, so now that you've seen our story, let's challenge your memory. Head on over to our 23 ABC News Facebook page and find out how good your memory actually is. We built an interactive game to help you test your skills to find out how you might do in a situation like that.
Really interesting story, all right.